This is KHQA Sports.
The number 11 Quincy University men's soccer team brought back some memories for the members of the 1980 NAIA National Championship team that stuck around for Sunday's game, and this one was a real beauty. The boys on the attack early in this one, and then you knew it was going to be ugly from the get-go. Jordan Roberts with some nice footwork to get the shot off on that. QU trying to test St. Joseph's keeper from just about anywhere on the field. Goals would start to come in bunches. Scott Laddie sends a perfect ball right here to Zobani Dokai. He doesn't miss many of those. Buries that one in the back of the net. That makes it 1-0 in favor of QU. In the seventh minute, QU would get another. Steve McCanny's going to send the corner. That's flicked by Michael Timmerman. Chris MacArthur is going to get his dome on that one. Puts it in the back of the net for his first collegiate goal right there. That makes it 2-0. 26th minute, Q&D's Taylor Reese on the attack right here. He's going to feed Mr. Jordan Roberts. And you know, Mr. Roberts, he's not going to miss that one. Puts that one into the mesh. 3-0 QU right there. They would go on and cruise today. No problem for the number 11th ranked team in the land as they get it done 9-0 today over St. Joseph's. The Lady Hawks also taking on St. Joseph's today, looking for their first win in their last three games. Goals have been hard to come by. Early on, QU would be all over the Pumas in their own end. Off the corner kick, it's going to get knocked around for a bit before Ashley Burton pounds one here. That one's going to get turned away right there. Hawks adding more heat after that. Through ball played in by Burton. Junior Haley Markway comes up with it. Going to put home. Nice off the side of the foot right there. That one goes in the back of the net. Burton would add one in the second half. And goalie Megan Swanson made just one save as QU goes on and gets the win by a final score of 2-0 today. Well, a huge day yesterday for Western Illinois as they took down number 10 Youngstown State and the best performance yet from quarterback Trent Norvell. As we take it to the highlights right now, close to 13,000 on hand, including YSU Penguin for this one. Thanks to WYTV for getting us these highlights. And it was the Trenton Norvell show right here. He's tall. He's lengthy. He can get it done on the ground right there. Picks up a chunky yardage. How about J.C. Baker, the human highlight reel? Get the ball in this man, missed man's hands. He's going to cruise up the sideline right there. Another big gain. And then Norvell threw four of them on the day. Here's one to Lance Lenore. 14-yard hookup right there. That's going to make it 7-3 in favor of WIU. We'd keep it going. Lenore, he'd be doing some more work out there. How about Norvell? Going to deliver a strike right here. How about the juggling act right here from Lenore to get his hands on that one, and you ain't going to catch him. He's got speed. He's got some burners. Far sideline into the crib right there. 49-yard catch. Touchdown right there, 14-3. And how about Camp Point's Nate Knuppen right here off the fake punt? He's got some wheels. No one can tackle him. He's going to pick up the first down into YSU territory. And from there, Norvell back to work. He's going to find High C Scott. What a name. What a grab right there. 3-yard touchdown grab. Caps off an 11-play, 54-yard touchdown drive. That makes it 27-17. That's going to do it. 30-24, they get it done yesterday. Norvell, the Missouri Valley Offensive Player of the Week after finishing 19-26, 291 yards, 4 TDs, a big win for Bob Nielsen and his crew yesterday. Well, it was another victorious and big day for a few local players from Central Methodist as they beat Culver Stockton yesterday afternoon. Mark Twain's Colin Sizemore, Skylar Jamison, and New London's Tyler Steinkamp all back in the Tri-States. It made the 44-30 win over the Wildcats even better with a bunch of familiar faces in the stands.
It's awesome. They are cheering and got signs, and I haven't seen that in a long time because I really didn't play last year, but this year it's awesome, and they love it.
It feels good. We had a lot of our teachers, a lot of our hometown guys here. I mean, it was really cool just hearing them cheer in the stands. They had signs made for all of us. It was pretty cool. I like being back home.
I mean, I've been playing football with Colin and Steinkamp since I was itty-bitty, so it's definitely nice to keep, play with them.
I love it. During spring and summer, I worked so hard, and it paid off, and now I'm playing for CMU.
We had Coach Hudson, Coach Epperson's right over there. He played at Central. I mean, it's just they just put us in the right path. They're just good coaches. We got good coaches here at Central. They've treated us pretty good.
Now, being former Culver recruits definitely made the win that much sweeter with the W, but representing where they learned the game and how to become young men definitely made this return home that much sweeter.
It feels pretty good to come out here and beat them. I mean, they were recruiting me and Skyler pretty hard, and it just feels good to come back home and beat them.
It's fast, but, I mean, it's fun. It's a lot of fun in the high school because these guys are all just as good as you, so you got to make some good plays or else it's not going to happen. But, yeah, I love it.
Colin and I actually went to the game last night, and it was a rough one against South Callaway, but South Callaway's pretty good. But it's definitely nice to go back and see all those guys. Hopefully they come to CMU. Hopefully they come up and see me and Colin and Steinkamp, even though me and Colin will be done after this year, but Steinkamp will still be there. But I definitely still have ties back at Mark Twain, and I'm proud of where I came from for sure.